Impersonation is seen to be the most frequent form of a spear phishing attack. So one of the most used tactics in spear phishing is to create a website with a domain name that replicates a well-known organization. Letters can be misused to fool unsuspecting users, and websites are all but utterly identical to the true site. One of the biggest giveaways of a spear phishing attempt can be found within the subject line itself. These subject lines will almost always attempt to bait you in terms of either urgency or sense of familiarity. Most popular subjects include requests, follow-up, urgent, importance, availability, payment stages. All of these terms impress some sense of familiarity. Some even go as far as using reply or forward it to make it appear as though it is a part of a conversation previously had. Many attachments included in spear phishing emails include embedded malware, or they will consist of forms where you need to enter your most sensitive information. Malware comes typically in the form of an .exe file. Other commonly used files are .zip files, PDF, Word, and Excel documents. Check the validity of the attachment by looking at who the email came from. This can be done easily by hovering your mouse over the from address. One of the latest techniques that hackers use in order to avoid detection from protection and security software is to use images instead of text. A spear phishing email is usually made up of your personal information found online, such as contact addresses or phone numbers, names of pets, and pretty much anything related to you that you wouldn't think could be found online. These targeted emails are very sophisticated, with attackers often opting to play the long game in that they attempt to build a relationship with their victim and gain trust. Spear phishing involves hackers accumulating as much personal information as possible in order to put their attack into action. Take care.